To improve performance, clients often cache parts of a web page. Caching can occur in multiple places. Your browser can cache some objects locally on your very machine. Caches can also be deployed in the network. Sometimes your local ISP may have a web cache. And later, we'll also look at how content distribution networks are a special type of web cache that can be used to improve performance. To see how caching can improve performance, consider the case where the origin web server may host the content for a particular website, but it's particularly far away. Now, we already know that TCP throughput is inversely proportional to round-trip time, so the further away that this web content is, the slower the web page will load, both because latency is bigger and because throughput is lower. If instead the client could fetch content from the local cache, performance could be drastically improved by fetching content from a more nearby location. Caching can also improve the performance when multiple clients are requesting the same content. In this case, not only do all of the local clients benefit from the content being cached locally, but the ISP also saves costs on transit because it doesn't have to pay to keep transferring the same content over these expensive links. Instead, it can simply serve the content to the clients locally. To ensure that clients are seeing the most recent version of a page, caches periodically expire content based on the expire setter that we already saw. Caches can also check with the origin server to see whether the original content has been modified. If the content has not been modified, the origin server would respond to a cache check request with a 304 or a not modified response. Clients can be directed to a cache in multiple ways. One is with browser configuration. So you can open your browser and explicitly configure the browser to point to a local cache so that all HTTP requests first are directed through the local cache before the request is forwarded to the origin. In the second approach, the origin server, or the service hosting the content, might actually direct your browser to a cache. This can be done with a special reply to a DNS request. We can see these effects, for example, when we do a DNS lookup for google.com. The response returns a number of IP addresses, and when I ping the IP address, we see that the resulting IP address is only 1 millisecond away, which indicates that that server is not far away, but is in fact very likely on the local network, probably even the Georgia Tech campus network in this case.